In order to add or subtract rational expressions, we must have the same or like denominators. So as soon as we notice we don't have like denominators, the first step is going to be to factor the denominators. So for this first example, we're going to write this as 7 over x times x, then we'll leave some space horizontally, plus 2 all over. Now we'll factor x squared plus 2x. Remember, the first step in factoring is to factor out the greatest common factor, which in this case would be x. So we'd have x times the quantity x plus 2. And if we want to have the same denominators, the denominators must contain the same factors. So notice that this fraction here contains a factor of x plus 2. So this fraction needs a factor of x plus 2 as well. So we can multiply the denominator by x plus 2 as long as we do the same to the numerator. Remember, anything over itself is equal to 1. So this is like multiplying by 1. But now notice the second fraction is missing a factor of x because this denominator has two factors of x. So we'll multiply this fraction by x over x. Now notice the denominators contain the same factors, and therefore we have like denominators. And now we can add by keeping the denominators the same and adding the numerators. So our common denominator is x squared times the quantity x plus 2. The first numerator is 7 times the quantity x plus 2 plus the second numerator of 2x. So now we'll clear the parentheses here and combine like terms in the numerator. Notice when we distribute here, we'll have 7x. 7x plus 2x would be 9x. And then we still have 7 times 2, that'll be positive 14, so we have plus 14. Now 9x plus 14 does not factor, so nothing is going to simplify here, and therefore we're done. Remember, we cannot simplify across addition or subtraction, so we're not able to simplify, for example, these x's here. Let's take a look at our second example. Again, we have different denominators, so the first step is to factor the denominators. So we'll have 12 over, this will factor into two binomial factors. First terms will be the factors of x squared, x and x. Now we want the factors of negative 3 that add to positive 2. That's positive 3 and negative 1. And we'll leave some room horizontally. Minus 12 all over, this will factor as well. Factors of x squared, x and x. The factors of 12 that add to 7, positive 4 and positive 3. And now to make the denominators the same, the denominators must contain the same factors. Notice how they already share a factor of x plus 3, but this fraction has a factor of x plus 4, so this one needs a factor of x plus 4. So we'll multiply by x plus 4 over x plus 4. And here, this denominator is missing a factor of x minus 1, so I'll multiply by x minus 1 over x minus 1. Notice now the denominators contain the same factors, and therefore we have our common denominator. Now we'll subtract. We'll keep the denominators the same and subtract the numerators. Remember, the order of these factors does not matter because they're connected by multiplication. So the first numerator would be 12 times the quantity x plus 4. And we have minus 12 times the quantity x minus 1. Now we're going to clear the parentheses in the numerator and combine like terms. So here we'll have 12x plus 48. And here, because of the subtraction, we'll think of distributing a negative 12. So we'll have negative 12x or minus 12x. And then negative 12 times negative 1 is positive 12, so we'll have plus 12. And now looking at the numerator, 12x minus 12x would be 0, and 48 plus 12 is equal to 60. So this would be our difference. Okay, I hope you found this helpful. We'll take a look at two more examples in the next video.